Good evening and welcome to the Whiskey Lover Society with me Gert de Tief, and tonight we are looking at the Belvinnie Doublewood 12 year old. Again, a nice sample from my online store here in Belgium. So this is bottle number 6. So when you do your order, they make a fresh bottle, put a number on, and they give you a list of all the whiskies that you have ordered, and they just put a number next to it. So it makes it quite fun, especially if you want to do a blind tasting at your home. This is fantastic fun, especially if you get all your friends together and you put the bottles out, and of course they can have a little bit of fun during the evening to guess what is the whiskey. So this is not a lot of information that they give you, which I also like. It doesn't taint my view of it. So they only give me, in this case, Belvinnie Doublewood 40% ABV, 12 year old, and of course how much it costs. So that is the information that I have, and that's the information that I'm going to go with. So nice color. I do suspect there is a little bit of coloring added, but if I will put it over here, if I do my research afterwards, to see if there is some color added. I know it is a double maturation. They have ex-bourbon casks. That's something that I've seen on the bottle. And of course, then they finish it off in ex-sherry casks, Oloroso sherry. So a nice little bit of a sherry bomb, or maybe not. So I'm just going to pour myself a small dram. Of course, you have to keep a little bit over so that I can share with my friends as well. So, color wise, like I said, it is a little bit on the dark side for a 12 year old, but it was in ex-sherry cask. So I do suspect that there is a little bit of color added, but it was finished in sherry cask. So it might be possible. Bottled at 40% ABV, so of course there will be some chill filtration. So a short one on the nose. It is really nice on the nose. A lot of the fruity flavors coming out. Dark fruits, real sherry notes. I do get a hint of the caramels. A little bit of a raisins coming out. There's a sweetness to it. A little bit of a butterscotch nose. Sultanas. Dried fruits. Hint of a cinnamon. And of course you get a little bit of the vanilla notes coming out from the ex-bourbon cask. This is really nice. Very sweet on the nose. A little bit of a honey note also coming out. But a light honey. It's not that dark, thick honey sweetness coming out. So quite pleasant on the nose. It also reminds me a little bit of a toffee apple with a nice big red apple on the inside. So sweet caramel, sweet toffee on the outside, and then the fruit on the inside. This is very pleasant. I remember I bought a bottle like this. I think I just moved into to Belgium, so that was about 6 years ago. And I went to the local store called the Dallas, and I was looking for some whiskey, and this is the first one that I saw. And of course that was on a nice special, and I paid around just over 40 euros for the bottle. So I was quite pleased with my purchase. And because it wasn't special, now I see they are going for 50 euros a bottle, also at the Dallas. So there's a little bit of an increase during the last 6 years. But of course, we all expect the increase to come, especially nowadays. A little bit of a rant. The prices of whiskey is getting a little bit crazy. there is some no age statement whiskies that keep on going up and up and up, and there's just no stopping it. And we the sheep, we just keep on buying it, and they create this little hype around a quick release, no age statement, and everybody must have it, and in the end it is nothing special. But of course we are the sheep, we are the ones that driving up the prices. And of course there is big influencers in YouTube, when they make a review of a whiskey and they tell us that it's going to be very expensive in the future, everybody wants to buy it, and of course that also drives up the prices. So for me, this one, not that cheap. So it's for me it's mid-level, hinting into the expensive side, but it's quite pleasant. Now I get a little bit of a apple note also coming out, like a apple juice, red apple juice. This is really pleasant for me. So on the taste, cheers. This is lovely, sweet, light, a little bit of a floral note coming out, raisins, figs, dates, dried fruit. Just putting a bunch of dried fruit in your mouth and you chew it, you get that nice juiciness coming out. And now I get a little bit of a dry mouthfeel. It's like the alcohol is removing removing all the juices from your tongue. It's a disgusting way of saying it, but it does give me a little bit of a dry mouthfeel. On the second sip, yeah, it does leave your mouth dry, but it leaves you a coating of fruit, dried fruit, raisins, a hint of a dark chocolate, well, maybe not dark chocolate, a little bit of an espresso note, a little bit of a Turkish coffee. So there is a bitterness in there, but it's not unpleasant. Quite balanced between the sweetness and the oak tannins coming out. It also reminds me a little bit of a marmalade. So there's a hint of an orange, and a hint of the marmalade bitterness. So quite pleasant, actually. Just give it one more try. Yep, the alcohol. The alcohol, you do get it, but at 40%, of course, it's not really in your face. And that little bit of a oaky spiciness also coming out. And the second sip was a little bit more oakier, and I suspect on the third sip it's going to be a tad more, but let's see. Yeah, I think on the second sip that created the top of the scale for me. The third sip, almost exactly the same, and it's really pleasant. So for me, quite surprised. I remember the first time I try this one, I was not that happy with it. For me, then it was a little bit on the oaky side. It's just strange how your palate evolves and you get used to different types of whiskies, and you also get climatized with regards to the oak. So for me, it is quite balanced. A little bit on the oaky side, but it is balanced between the sweetness and the oak. And for me, this is something that I will definitely buy again as a little bit of a daily sipper. I think this is fantastic. Lovely nose on it. All this, it keep on giving more and more and more. I do love the nose. The taste is a little bit disappointing. It's not exactly the same as the nosing notes, but it's not unpleasant. So I do like it. So I will recommend it. I'm not going to add any water to it. At 40%, it's not necessary. This might also be fantastic in a cocktail, a little bit of old fashioned. I think that will also be very nice. So that's me. Like the bell, Vinnie. Tell me. Put a comment. Do you like it? Have you tried it? What do you think about it? Remember to like and subscribe, or don't like, but subscribe. And I see you next time. Cheers.